Well, good morning. Welcome to New Thought Unity Center on this lovely Sunday morning. We're glad that you're here. And it's time to wake up. Here we go. Today I wake up, give up hope of a different past. Today I stop blaming who I was and start being who I am. Thank you, Mother. Thank you, Father. My vision's finally clear. I trust you gave all you had to give, and it's time for me to take it from here. Today I wake up, face to the sun, stand still for a moment, there's no place to run. Today I lay down. That story I've been telling for so long. Today I clear a space for my soul to sing its pure and simple song. Thank you, heartache. Thank you, pain. My path is finally clear. I've decided I don't need to cling to you again. Well, it's time for me to take it from here. Huh. Today I wake up, face to the sun. Stand still for a moment, there's no place to run. Peg. Thank you very much, and welcome to New Thought Unity Center, and we have a few announcements. There's a lot going on at the center, and we're putting the announcements at the beginning so you can get those, and we have this flow of energy from there on out. So, I've got how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 announcements to do in a minute and a half. Here we go. Angel's Wings retail shop open today. Be sure to stop in after the service to browse for new fall merchandise. I'm going to get my long sleeve shirts over there today. Gallery of Grace gift shop open today. Out the door, right around there. Unique gifts, and some of them smell really good. You should check those out. A Course in Miracles book study. And Susan continues her wisdom of the wonderful book. September the 20th, 6:30, in person here
and a $5 love offering suggested. The four agreements, who can say them? Who has them written in their heart and in their mind? Well, even if you do, there is a book study. It begins on the 14th. Wait a minute, what is today? Ah, it already began. But can they still get in? They can still get in. All right, Susan Whitrock, this four-week course begins, and it's and then the next one is it's on the 14th, and then in October, goes through October. Right, all right. What day is it on? Wednesday evening. All right, so check that out, in person and via Zoom. Crossport, if you don't know what that is, check it out. Contact Lauren Watson or for the center for more information. Mastermind, Awaken the Mastermind Consciousness, facilitated by Alice Frazier. That's on Wednesdays, too. On October the 10th, 6:30 in Friendship Hall, a growth mindset fuels your potential. Alice is going to be speaking here in just a few weeks. Karaoke, October the 7th at 7 o'clock in Friendship Hall, and DJ Kim is going to be there. And we're going to pull out the songs that we know how to sing. Wow. Everybody do this. Give you W's and put O. Wow. Women of Wisdom, Saturday, October the 15th, 10 a.m. to noon. David McClanahan is going to be the first male speaker in a while, if ever. Joyous Spirituality, Part 2. All right, a love offering is suggested for that. Pre-register for this gathering. The nominating committee needs someone. See a board member if you are interested in serving on the nominating committee to select future board members. And finally, join us in Friendship Hall after the meeting, and we will have a wonderful gathering there, and we always talk about all kinds of things. We never gossip. We just talk about positivity, right, and love. All right. Speaking of which, I look out, and I see you, and I see the world, and I see that it's beautiful, and we're going to do a little of this as we go.
A remarkable place, a beautiful house in a forest of stars in outer space. From a bird's eye view, I can see it as a well-rounded personality. From a bird's eye view, I can see we are family. It's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you. No, it's not a difficult thing. It's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you, because you are the world to me. The world as I see it is a remarkable place. Every man makes a difference. Every mother's child is just a saint. From a bird's eye view, I can see we are spiraling down in gravity. From a bird's eye view, I can see you are just like me. It's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you. No, it's not a difficult thing. It's not hard for me to love you, oh, I really love you, unconditionally. No, it's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you. No, it's not a difficult thing. It's not hard for me to love you, oh, I really love you. Love, you are the world to me. You are the mountain, you are the rock. You are the core, you are the spark. You are the eagle, you are the lark. You are the bird, and you're remarkable. You're the ocean meeting the that shore. You are the calm inside the storm. Through every emotion you can endure. You are the world. It's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you, because you are the world.
Sing it this time with us. Here we go.
No, it's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you. No, it's not a difficult thing. It's not hard for me to love you, hard for me to love you, because you are the world to me. The world as I see it is a remarkable place.
All right. Well, good morning. And we're going to start with an affirmation this morning. Who wants to do the affirmation? Can you do the affirmation out, Thea, and lead us in a prayer afterwards?
And the affirmation for this morning is, through the changes, I remain curious, compassionate, grateful, and kind. Say that with me, please.
Through the changes, I remain curious, compassionate, grateful, and kind.
Good morning, New Thought Unity Center. Good morning, world. Here in Cincinnati is a bright, sunshiny day, and the doors of the church are open, so people can come on in. Come on in and feel the love that is expressed here, the love that is shared here, the music, the fellowship, and all of the goodness that we represent here at this city. The world, as we see it, is a remarkable place on this bright, sunshiny day. So let's just breathe in, hold it a second, and release. And so it is. Amen.
Now's the time when we stand on our feet and sing together, Divine Spirit in Me. Thank you. And now's the time when we greet each other with a handshake or a hug and say hello to our spiritual family. We'd like to welcome everyone that's joining us on our Facebook Live broadcast through the miracle of the interweb. We welcome you here. Please tell us who you are and where you're listening from and what you like about this wonderful celebration this morning.
Woo! I feel a good vibration, healing and transformation all through this congregation. Must be unity, the experience is our mission. Universal wholeness is our vision. I am who I am, it's my decision. Must be unity. NTUC unity. Yeah.
Man. Please have a seat if you would. We can continue this fellowship after the service in Friendship Hall. Say with me, please, our mission and vision statements. Our mission statement is, in God, we are an inclusive, abundant community experiencing love, transforming lives, and serving others. And our vision statement is, we celebrate a world of harmony and oneness, a place of loving stewardship, sacred connections, and pure joy, where all are welcome with honor and respect. And what we want you to know more than anything is that whoever you are, regardless of your race, your gender, your nationality, your age, your sexual orientation, your gender identity, or your neurodiversity, you are welcome here. And wherever you are on your spiritual path, we're grateful for your presence this morning. So thank you. If you are new to the center, or if you have any questions, there is a newcomer's table in the back of the sanctuary. There is a packet of information with a gift for you in it, and Regina will be back there after the service, and she can answer any questions that you may have. Again, thank you for being with us this morning.
Yes, and as is our practice, we're going to go into silent meditation. There's a few things you can count on in life, and one of them is that we're going to spend 2 minutes in silence here every Sunday morning. Do you ever get 2 minutes of silence anywhere else? Maybe, maybe not. But here, we're going to let the music today take us into the wonderful shared meditation. It feels different when I'm here and you're in silence and I'm in silence. And there's something in this room that happens that brings a clarity and a light inside of me. So I look forward to that today as we sing into silence and sing out.
I feel peace. if you look towards heaven on any given night, you may see the stars glowing, shining ever bright. But are they really shining or just burning in the sky? Well, maybe they're a little bit of both at the same time. Have you ever loved somebody, felt so good it hurt, but then they went running when you dug up all the dirt? Was it only lust, or is love also a curse? Well, maybe they're a little bit of both in reverse. How come some days you're living and other days it's death? How come everything you've been given somehow always leads to death?
How come
joy needs sorrow and reason don't rhyme until your horizontal life ain't a straight line? Well, maybe we're all a little bit of everything combined. Well, feel like Superman, but I don't have no cape to fly. Wanna push up against the atmosphere, getting gravity defied. But is it really flying, or is falling redefined? Well, maybe it could be a boat both at the same time. How come some days you're living and other days it's death?
How come
everything that's given somehow always leads to death?
How come
joy needs sorrow and sorrow and don't rhyme until your horizontal life ain't a straight line? Well, maybe we're all a little bit of everything combined. Maybe we're a little bit of both. Everything withers after it grows. Maybe we're a little bit of both at the same time. Well, some days you're living and other days it's dead.
How come
everything that's given somehow always leads to death?
How come
joy sorrow and reason don't rhyme until your horizontal life ain't a straight line? Well, maybe we're all a little bit of, maybe we're all a little bit of, maybe we're all a little bit of everything combined.
Amen.
Well, good morning again. It's great to be back. I was gone for, was I gone for 2 weeks in a row? Wow, okay. And it's always great to come home. But we're talking about a bit of both today, how there's a little paradox in our lives, or one thing is happening, the other thing is happening at the same time. And so, and that's the way I'm feeling these days. This is home. It's been home for how many years now? And then I go away. I have a relationship with a wonderful woman and that lives 2,000 miles away. And so, and when I get there, it feels like home too. Both is happening. Both is, that's home. This is home. It's transition. Anybody else in a transition in their lives? Okay. Everybody, we're transitioning one time or another. I reviewed a talk that I gave, and it's going to be about pretty much the same talk that I gave in 2013. Who was here in 2013? Anybody? A few people. And I started with a movie clip from Forrest Gump. There he is. Forrest Gump said one of the most, it's interesting, he in the movie, of course, he was in love with Jenny. Everybody know the story of Forrest Gump. And he said, Jenny, why don't you love me? And she couldn't answer. He said, I'm not a smart man, but I know what love is. We do, don't we? We feel things inside ourselves. But the quote I want to get to is Forrest Gump, just as a review, born in the 40s, taught Elvis how to do his moves because he had braces on his legs, right? And so he lives through a desegregation, through the Vietnam War. He loses his best friend, but they made a pact that they were going to be shrimp boat owners, and so he goes and gets a shrimp boat. Lieutenant Dan was supposed to die in war. That was his destiny, right? But Forrest Gump saved him. And then Lieutenant Dan said, you ruined my life. What? You know? But then they reconcile, and they come together at the end. His mother dies of cancer. And her philosophy was, life is like a box of chocolates. What's the next line? Never know what you're going to get. And so, and then Jenny passes away too, probably of AIDS in the early 80s. They maybe didn't even have a name for it at that point. And he's standing over her grave. And he says, you know, I don't know if it's Mama or if it's Lieutenant Dan. I don't know if we all have a destiny or if we're all floating accidental-like on a breeze, but maybe it's both. Maybe both is happening at the same time. That is the clearest explanation of this duality that we live in that I've ever heard. Both is happening at the same time. How can we be one when I'm standing here and I'm looking out and we're all in individual bodies, but is there only one person here? Yes, both is happening at the same time. So we're going to explore that idea a little bit today as we go, but really we could just end it right here because both is happening. Do you get it? We get it mentally, but sometimes we don't feel that way, do we? Especially when we're mad at some other person. How can we both be the same person when you are so wrong and I am so right? Right? When sorrow comes, man, I've been doing meditations on happiness for however, and this is just a day when I feel really, really sad. Yeah. And those people, and let's recognize the political divide way over here on the right, way over here on the left. And we get in our silos and we look up the websites that reinforce what we believe. And all of a sudden we're villainizing and calling evil people that are just trying to find the same answers we are to these social questions, to these ways of living. That we're in these days. Hard to stand in the middle and understand both sides. So, Forrest Gump said it well. Another person that said it well was Thomas Merton. You know, Thomas Merton was a saint in my, but an amazing scholar, and he was just in the Trappist monk monastery. Just a few miles from here down in Kentucky. And here's what he said. He took a trip to town, and he was standing, he said, in Louisville at the corner of 4th and Walnut. Well, Walnut, it's been changed to Muhammad Ali Boulevard. Does anybody know Louisville at all? So they're right there. In Louisville, at the corner of 4th and Walnut, in the center of the shopping district, I was suddenly overwhelmed with the realization that I loved all these people, and that they were mine and I theirs, that we could not be alien to one another, even though we were total strangers. It was like waking from a dream of separateness, of spurious self-isolation in a special world. The sense of liberation from an illusory difference was such a relief and such a joy to me that I almost laughed out loud. I had an immense joy of being man, a member of a race in which God Himself became carnate. As if the sorrows and stupidities of the human condition could overwhelm me, now that I realize what we all are. If everybody could realize this, but it cannot be explained. There's no way of telling people that they are all walking around shining like the sun. Then it was as if suddenly I saw the secret beauty of their hearts, the depths of their hearts where neither sin nor desire nor self-knowledge can reach, the core of their reality, the person that each one is in God's eyes. If only they could see all, if only they could all see themselves as they really are. If we could only see each other that way all the time, there would be no more war, no more hatred, no more cruelty, no more greed. But this cannot be seen, only believed and understood by a particular gift. Touches me so to think of that quote of him just standing there. Saying, we're all one. There's a great Sufi legend of the Sufi who laughed all the time. And they say, why are you laughing all the time? He says, it's so hilarious. We're all these people walking around looking for enlightenment when they're already enlightened. They're already whole and beautiful beings. And they don't realize it. Also, someone who said this very, very well, and I think I left the book at home on my bedstand, so I'm just going to go to Khalil Gibran and tell you what I remember. Sorrow and joy. Do you ever have a problem reconciling those two things, sorrow and joy? And what he said in the prophet was, sorrow, joy is sorrow unmasked. We would never know sorrow if we didn't have. We would never know joy if we didn't have the sorrow. We would never know what a straight line is unless we have a crooked line. We wouldn't have anything to compare the day to the beautiful sunlight unless there was the night. Joy and sorrow are the same thing in just different manifestations, both at the same time. So I'm interested by the thing that Thomas Merton said. You can't just explain this. It's hard to hold these two things at the same time. That one thing that seems seemingly opposed to the other thing is existing at the same time. And so as we look, so the way to do it is to experience it. It says we just have to experience that. Have you ever had an experience and you say, whoa, it's hard for me to explain, but it was this wonderful feeling. And that's what we're talking about. But what we can do is use the four things in our affirmation today to experience this both at the same time, a bit of both that I'm talking about. So curiosity. I was at a conference last weekend. I was in Santa Fe, New Mexico last weekend. Wonderful place to be, the high desert, and there's just such a spirituality and a feeling there. And there was a talk on curiosity and being curious in these times when we are so polarized and we're thinking about different things. And the two things that that kill curiosity are certainty and fear. If you're absolutely certain about something, then how are you going to be curious about anything else? You put up a wall of certainty. Now, it feels nice to have this room of certainty around. I know this to be true. Nobody can convince me otherwise. Well, guess what? That's where your growth stops. Even the things that I am the most sure about in my life, I leave a little opening. Have you ever been dead sure about something and 10 years later you look back on that and say, what? Right? So if we're absolutely certain, then curiosity is going to stop. Say, okay, as far as I know, from my experience so far, I'm pretty certain about this thing. But I'm going to leave a little opening before we go. And if you're afraid, those walls come up too. Oh, this is too scary. I'm going to go back to what I know. That does not leave room for this development of knowing both at the same time. You know that parable in the Bible. I'm going to talk about the rebel Jesus a little more later on. But where it says, the wise man built his house upon a rock. Remember that? And the rain came tumbling down and his house stayed. And the foolish man built his house upon the sand. Now, I've talked about the Jesus seminar several times from here. Jesus probably did not say that. It was in the folklore of the time. A lot of preachers before him had given that little parable and saying, somebody's put it in there. A lot of the things in the Bible are words that somebody else put in the mouth of Jesus to either promote their version of what they think he was or should have been. Jesus was never a Christian. He was a Jew until they killed him. There's no evidence. There are some writings, and you can go to scripture verses, but those were about 100 years after he died. There's no evidence that he ever wanted to establish a church or a religion. He wanted to shake things up. He wanted to say, let's take a look at this. Let's be curious about things. Let's not just go along this path because somebody has walked it before us and told us that we should, but let's go inside ourselves and really have free will and do the things that our hearts and our minds lead us to do. So it's staying curious is absolutely important in being able to find this paradox or live this both things at the same time. The second thing would be, before we lead curious, let's go back. Where are we? Grateful? We're curious? Curious. If you're absolutely sure, it reminds me of three people in an airplane that was about to crash with only two parachutes. You know this story? Smartest man in the world, the president of the United States, and a Boy Scout. And the smartest man in the world says, I am the smartest man in the world. I need to be saved. So he got a parachute and he jumped out of the plane. The president and the scout are looking at each other. And the president says, young man, you are the future of the world. I'm going to give you the last parachute and I'll perish with the plane. The Boy Scout said, Mr. President, no problem. The smartest man in the world just jumped out with my backpack. When you think you know for sure, you can't be curious about everything else. Right. All right, now let's go back. Let's go to the next one, compassion. To be compassionate. Whoop, be compassionate. There was a step. That means I should come down here. I love the arrangement of the word. Come with passionness. Right? We share our passion with one another. We be compassionate. And there's a great story Stephen Covey told. Let's see what time it is. He was on a subway in New York, and a man got on with three small children, and the man sat down and just kind of went into a stupor, and the children were running all around the subway car and bothering people, and besides the fact they may be going to hurt themselves, I mean, they were just running around. They should be sitting down. Stephen Covey went over to the man and said, excuse me, sir, your children are running all around. And the man said, oh, I'm so sorry. You see, their mother died, and we just came from the funeral. This indignation, this, why can't this man keep care of his kids, turned to what? Pure compassion in that moment. Oh, I'm so sorry. Is there anything I can do? What can we do to help? Everybody just rallied around the man now and those children. We don't know why somebody cuts us off in traffic or somebody's irritable one day or another. Can we have the compassion without knowing the story behind it? That's the practice, is to be compassionate and loving no matter what. That leaves the room open for the two things we're talking about. Next, we can be grateful, thankful for all the things that we have. I always feel, you know, sometimes I think, oh, really? I'm going to make a gratitude list. And there's a 12-step group that I've been attending for a long time. And, you know, when no one has an issue to talk about, you know, we have a couple of issues. Somebody said, let's talk about gratitude. And people groan, you know, like, oh, gratitude again. But gratitude, when we think and when we enumerate and when we can bring that feeling of gratefulness up in our hearts, that leaves the door open so that we can understand this odd paradox that we're sometimes living with. Gratitude. Let's be grateful. And finally, kindness. To be kind. That song by Jewel, in the end, only kindness matters. You can love, you can be smart, but if you're cruel on top of all of those things, no. We're kind with one another. And I get to the rebel Jesus as we come to the end of my time. The things that he most probably said, the five big ones, have to do with kindness. And they have to do with what we're talking about today, this paradox. Turn the other cheek. If somebody hits you on the left side, turn the other cheek to the right side. Does that make any sense? Yes, it does, but not at first. And it's about kindness. If someone asks you for your coat, give him your shirt also. Man, he was what? I'm going to give away my wealth to a stranger that asks for me? Congratulations to the poor. Blessed are the poor. That's the way they translate it. Congratulations, poor people, because you're going to have everything. Back in the day, the Roman soldiers could ask you to carry their armor for a mile. A mile's a long way. If a soldier asks you to carry armor for a mile, carry it 2 miles. That was what Jesus taught. Kindness. And my favorite, it came in number 5 on the Jesus Seminar list. 3 words that I have been pondering for my entire life since I read them first and don't quite have the answer yet. Love your enemies. And you know what I found out lately? It's not y'all. It's the ones inside of me. The enemy inside. The thing that says, David, you're not good enough. David, you're a fake. If people really knew who you were, they wouldn't love you. Those are the enemies that I'm loving. I can't banish them out because, you know, the things that you try to banish out just stay and get stronger. But if I love that little person inside of me that doesn't think he's good enough, that's when it starts to. When I have love for myself, I can have it for everyone else. So we're back to Forrest Gump. Maybe both.
is happening at the same time. That we do have a destiny. We do have something that we're supposed to do. And yet, random things are happening as well. And that's what Jesus taught. Get in touch with your own free will and make those decisions for yourself. So, as the band comes up, I want to talk about this last song a little bit, Both Sides Now. Did anybody see the movie Coda? The one best picture for, I think it was last year. Yes. A child of deaf adults, C-O-D-A, Coda. And this young girl was born into a deaf family. They had a fishing boat, and all she wanted to do was sing. And she had to convince her family to let her. I actually haven't seen the movie, but I saw the end. And in the end, she's auditioning for Berklee School of Music, and she sings this song, Both Sides Now. And as she sings, her family comes in into the top balcony. And in the middle of the song, she starts signing it so that they can hear what she's singing. I've looked at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all. The more we know, the more we have to learn. That's the curious, compassionate, grateful, kind way to embrace a bit of both.
Flows of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air and feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way. Now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done. Clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's cloud illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all.
The dizzy dancing way you feel as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing where you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow is love's illusion I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. But now, old friends, they're acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. But something lost, but something's gained. They're living every day. From both sides now, from win and lose, and still
Well, it's that time in our service where we do our offertory blessing. So if you get your tithes and your offering ready and say our offertory blessing with me. And it goes like this. Let's say it together. Divine love, moving in and through me, blesses and multiplies all that I give and all that I receive. And our chaplains here today are Lauren and Susanna. And we as chaplains hold sacred space before, during, and after service. So if you have a prayer request, please see a chaplain after service. They'd be glad to pray with you. And we thank you for giving online. We thank you for giving at the little credit card in the back machine. And we just thank you that you are here to share your prosperity with New Thought Unity Center. David?
Good morning from C.P. Williams. Good morning from Randy Mayo in the great Northeast Ohio. Sam Elliston from Hyde Park. James McLean from Kennedy Heights in Sandy. From Roselawn are all online and saying good morning this morning. We want to thank everyone that's participated today in our program. We want to, who's back there? That's the Barb and Terry back in the booth making a scene and heard
thank
all
you.
Around the world. And we have Susan making us heard here in the sanctuary
thank
and
you.
Sending that sound out. What about the Unity Band, ladies and gentlemen?
Woohoo!
Michael, Randy, and Peg. The A-Team, Alice and Althea, singing our songs. And a blessing on the offering.
So, sweet, sweet Spirit, we thank you for these tithes and these offerings. We thank you for blessing the hearts of those in this center and those that are online, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. Volunteer at New Thought Unity Center and give of your times, your talents, as well as your treasures. And the work that this does for this center works also for the community. We are grateful, and so it is.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to thank the Board of Trustees, and we want to thank all those that volunteer at the center. Always room for more who want to come and share their time and their talent with us here. And so now it's time that we stand and find a hand to hold as we know our prayer for protection and our peace song. With gratitude in our hearts for all that we've experienced today and just the joy of being together. And so we know our prayer for protection.
The light of God surrounds me.
The love of God enfolds me.
The power of God protects me.
The presence of God watches over me.
Wherever I am, God is, and all is well.
On earth and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, a peace that was meant to be. With God our Creator, children all are we. Let us walk with each other.
Take each moment and live each moment.
chorus of both sides now. One, two, three.
Looked at life that way, but now, oh friends, they're acting strange. They shake their head, they say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but